The MJ Estate's new cartoon, Michael Jackson's Halloween, aired on CBS on October 27, 2017. It begins with Don't Stop Till You Get Enough being wiki-wiki'd by some white kid who works in a grocery store. We also meet a clumsy office intern who gets tasked with looking after her boss's dopey dog. Yeah. Then we're teased with the reveal of MJ. There's the sparkling glove, the socks, the loafers, and a remote control. How is that MJ? Rather than use his magic, it's the mere press of a button that leads to the building of the Burton-esque hotel. Following the title card, we see a flying shot of a cold-ankled bat heading towards the new structure while we listen to the song, This Place Hotel. The bat makes a long, scenic flyover past the mansion, all the way up to the bell tower, where he meets the assistant chimp.
I'll wait for the delivery. Good luck with the targets.
And a whole 6 seconds after arriving, the bat leaves again and takes us on another flyover sequence, this time to the tune of Xscape. Wait, why did the bat fly up to the mansion? We already saw a wide shot of the mansion in full before the title card, so it wasn't an establishing shot. There was talk online a few weeks back after John Schwarz of bubbleblabber.com saw an incomplete version of the special and wrote that the plot was horrid. I wonder what kind of changes were made between such screenings and its premiere on CBS. I have a feeling that little bat and chimp bullshit sequence was an attempt to polish this incohesive turd. So we hear a mashup of the modernised Xscape and Rockwell's Somebody's Watching Me. I'd love to know what Rockwell thinks of that song being used by the estate in ways like this. And then we're assaulted with no less than 16 painful seconds of the Billie Jean beat being screamed over by these two characters after one crashes into the other on a bicycle. Yeah, nice exposition. Just have one character smash into the other one. Backstory of how they met? Done. Oh, and then we never hear Billie Jean again. So the Xscape Somebody's Watching Me mashup was abruptly stopped and replaced with the Billie Jean beat for no reason other than for it to be screamed over. So they go to the mansion and meet the chimp, which has been called fucking Bubbles. Can you believe this shit? Before being teleported to a garden in an elevator playing Human Nature. Are they saying that Human Nature is just elevator music? It made me think about how this use of MJ's expansive catalogue will inevitably be the soundtrack to a Hollywood feature film at some point. Think Mamma Mia for ABBA. You can just see it up in lights now, can't you? Executive producer John Branca gives Sony Pictures the box office smash of the year with the goat's vibrato. Then we have the Jam Dangerous mashup in a steroid-riddled pumpkin patch. We see this pumpkin-headed stick figure strike pose after pose in an embarrassingly low-rent homage to the skeleton in Michael's film Ghosts. If you pay attention, just after you see the crow for the second time, it appears that Pumpkin Jackson fails an attempt at the smooth criminal lean. Well, that's how I saw it anyway. Sure, Michael didn't get it right every time he performed it, but to actually animate his character in a cartoon to fuck up the lean is a bit weird. Though he does do the lean later successfully on top of a giant pumpkin, so I guess all is right in the world. And then we meet the antagonist, conformity. Michael's such a poster child for individuality that the bad guy is conformity. But of everything wrong with this show, I actually kind of like that. Encouraging kids to be themselves. Oh, and she's played by Lucy Liu, which was an unexpected surprise. She always gives good villain. And what's the story with the animations? They look like something off a PlayStation 2 game. Were they even all done by the same team? Some scenes are better than others, but it is really all a bit sloppy. To put it into perspective, Toy Story 1 came out in 1995 and is far superior in every way. Anyway, before you know it, the main characters are being charged with a series of crimes including the spreading of subversive music by a character that's been clearly modelled on the Big Spider from This Is It. They Don't Care About Us is then heavily pillaged. It's like a team of disinterested mini-millennials saw a YouTube video once of They Don't Care About Us from the History Tour and just liked the marching bit. And then they apply the nothing to see here filter by brutally and abruptly hacking out the parts of the songs that are inconvenient to the establishment. Subversive indeed. The antagonist, Conformity, keeps popping up to scold people for dancing. I can't believe they didn't do a cutaway to a no toe standing street sign. Then blood on the dance floor is thrown in a blender, and whatever remained was tacked onto the show for good measure. I'm surprised the stained glass window featured the Dangerous album cover, instead of the estate's latest stillborn effort, which they've inappropriately named Scream. Then we're forced to endure a routine with MJ in feline form, set to the Jackson song Torture. I guess the only authentic thing about this is that, like the music video, Michael ain't really in it. A series of zombies and skeletons start pouring in, and thriller video MJ comes to life to save the day. The animated character is a disaster. Body movements are rigid, and the mouth doesn't even move. What else happens? A mummy gets stripped naked. A dog pisses on feline Jackson's foot.
Oh, that smells like justice.
That's something. The whole thing's just too snappy. Everything happens a bit too fast. It's roughly 45 minutes long, an hour with ads for TV. If it had been longer and the pacing slowed down a little, it would have let the audience follow what was going on and allowed the music to better nourish the scenes. But this is a cartoon for children. The main characters, who personify the target demographic, are even referred to by the chimp as targets. That silhouette used repeatedly throughout the show, on the pumpkin, on the door, the wallpaper, the bottom of the stained glass window, the trapdoor, it's not even one of the iconic silhouettes from Michael's time, like on the number ones and ultimate collection artwork. This is the one created by the estate, I believe with the help of an impersonator, for the This Is It movie poster. The number plate on the stretched Bugatti says I'm bad, with the bad logo, but not the real bad logo, the one with the crown from the estate's Bad 25 reissue. All in all, will this be good for Michael Jackson's legacy? Actually, I do think it has the potential to attract a shit ton of new young fans who will see this and then go exploring Michael's work, especially if it makes its mark past this particular Halloween. Like a home media release? If they put an extended cut of this on a DVD, I can imagine it becoming a go-to Halloween tradition where families sit around and watch it together every year. All the estate's current output seems to be in that vein, reinforcing Michael as a Halloween icon, so I can only assume they want this special to have a life longer than its hour on CBS in 2017. At the end of the special, we hear a recording of Michael's voice say, "Keep trying, don't give up, just believe in yourself." Beautiful words, but the dreadful audio quality of that recording is a stark reminder that Michael really is gone, and no amount of budget animation or uninspired music remixing is going to change that. Okay, bye.